A person who does not travel reads only one book of the world. World is like a big book, and those who doesn't travel reads only one page of it. Good afternoon, Toastmasters. Exactly 2 years back, I got an excellent chance to travel to China from Motorola and explore one more page of this book. I would like to share my experience with all of you today, because this one trip, I don't know why, it made me enjoy a lot. I explored the whole China, at least Beijing. I did so many things. I was all alone. I could travel, I could eat, I could do all the things that I wanted all the time, and I had a great time. So this is one trip I would love to share with all of you. People. China people were very different. I don't know why I felt that. English was a problem, but I discovered that there's one more very powerful language in this world, sign language. Though I couldn't talk to many of the people, they helped me a lot. One day I was looking for an address, I could not find the address, and I asked the lady. I had a chit written in Chinese. She read it. She tried telling me the way in English, but she fell short of the words. Then she remembered two words, English words, and used it very effectively. She said, "Follow me," and she walked all the way to the destination to show me the place. That was an excellent thing. And once I was taking a photograph, I had asked a guy to click a photograph of mine. And when I was posing for the photo, I saw one old lady coming towards me running. I got a bit scared, but she came to me and said, "The way you're wearing the hat is not looking good." She changed it, and then only he allowed the guy to click my photo. So these guys are very different, very friendly. You know, they go out of the way to help you. They have superstitions. I have not this much of superstitions in India. They have beliefs and superstitions. Their language is very, very different. Even the way you pronounce it changes the meaning of the word. For example, ma is mother, whereas ma is horse. So you cannot make out what the person is telling until they finish the entire sentence. So if you have observed a Chinese, they'll not talk until you have finished the word. Finish the entire sentence. I tried talking to a colleague of mine and he used to look at the roof. Initially, I didn't understand what he was doing. Only after I completed, he took a small pause, only then he started talking. Then I understood that's because of the way their language is structured. So, they have the superstition, they feel the word eight, you know, sounds similar to prosper, so it's a very lucky number. They pay hundreds of rupees, thousands of rupees to get a phone number which has an 8 in it. And 4 is unlucky because it sounds like death. But 5 means not. So if you use 5 with 4, may 54, not death, good. But 58 is bad. So that's this kind of lot of superstitions are there. And this one bangle, jade bangle, is very auspicious for them. They think this jade bangle is very lucky, but you guys have to be very careful. When the girl gets married, they make her wear a girl, jade bangle. If you look after her well, it turns dark green. Otherwise, it will become light green, revealing all your secrets. They believe it, and everybody wears a bangle like this. I went to a park called Rutan Park. And that was a very beautiful park. I felt as if I had gone to some heaven or somewhere. It was a very beautiful park, so I have put a picture of that there. But the people there, they were doing different things. I saw some ladies practicing some dance. I thought they're practicing for the Olympics, because I know Olympics was few weeks away. But that's the way they are. They always practice all those dances, everything in the park. All old ladies were practicing dance. All young people were practicing Tai Chi, some girls were practicing singing, and some old people, old men, they had a small cage next to them where some birds were kept. They were singing and they played cards listening to the singing of the birds. So that is something very different I saw in these parks. Then their culture. I was walking in a shop, walking in the shopping streets, and I saw some beautiful paintings. I liked it very much. I went and inquired, but they were very expensive, especially the puppy I liked very much. So they, it was not in my reach. It was pretty expensive. When I was leaving the shop, I noticed that was not a painting, but that was embroidery. Complete embroidery. They take months together to do these embroideries. That's why it's so highly priced. The other painting that I saw was a small bottle, and the artist paints from the mouth of the bottle. They put the brush and they paint it in the reverse order. So whatever you want to see first has to be painted first, and then they go painting the other background, everything. So that's a beautiful thing which I noticed, and that's also pretty highly charged. I have a small video. When I was there, I attended some of the shows also. One of that was acrobatic show, which was excellent, full of energy, and the guys there. I just want you to take a look at it. Amazing ones. So inspired by this, maybe you can look at it later. I also attended something called Peking Opera. They do dramas in a musical language, but it's little difficult to tolerate the shrieking voice of the heroine for entire 1 hour. This was one of the cultural, Chinese culture, very important things. And nothing is complete without exploring the food of the land. And love for food is one sincere thing which no other love can replace. So this is Peking duck, where a duck is roasted and it's an expert chef cuts exactly 128 pieces out of it, and you have to eat it with the bread and the chapati kind of thing there. And there's one interesting food street which is there in China. You get all kinds of insects there. You can see cockroaches, some lizards, some silkworm. This is one interesting thing. I wanted to eat something in this state. I tried a lot. I moved up and down, but couldn't gather courage to try out anything. But then one old person called me and said, "No meat, no meat. I'm going to cook something for you." And he made me some kind of fried rice and made me eat that. So today he made me capable of standing here and saying, "I ate in the street." Yeah, thank you. So there is a This world is very beautiful. If you keep your eyes open, there's so many things that you can do in this world. Thank you.
That was indeed a very entertaining speech that Sharvari gave us. A lot of new things we need to learn about the culture and...
Sharvari,
yeah. And if you want to record...